Okay, congratulations, sir. How do you describe this victory for APC?
Victory is always sweet. We worked very hard, and I think we deserve it. And this country deserves us to move to the next level. So we are very happy.
What are we expecting to see from you? What is new that you are bringing to the table?
Well, the problems of Nigeria are well known. We'll consolidate on what we are doing and try to move faster and more efficiently.
Okay. What's your name, sir?
Suleiman Adamu, Minister of Water Resources.
Could you describe this victory for APC?
Well, this is we thank God Almighty for this victory, and this is a very important victory because of the lofty ideals and, of course, the programs of government under the presidentship of Muhammadu Buhari. So we believe that this is a demonstration of the confidence of the Nigerian people once more on the president and indeed our great party, the All Progressive Congress.
Great.
So this further confirms that Nigerians appreciate what the government had been doing in the last 4 years and certainly would want it to be moved to the next level. So we appreciate we appreciate the confidence once more reposed in this government and in our president.
Great. So what's your name, sir?
Umar Ibrahim Eliaku. And I'm the Senior Special Assistant to the President, National Assembly Matters, House of Representatives.
When your hands are clean and your heart is clean and you have good intention, no matter the gathering of the clouds, God will always deliver you. That's what God has done for APC, that's what God has done for President Buhari, and that's what God has done for Nigeria. So we're believing that we're going higher to the next level. We're inviting all the hands to come over and work with us. Those who had grievances and left, they have skills, let them come back. Nigeria needs their services and their hands.
We work for, and Nigeria appreciate what we have done for the past few years. So that's why they want to give us the re-election. So it's a free thing we have to guide jealously, really. Because we have to give the Nigerian the best. If we don't give Nigeria the best and consolidate, that's why we say we are taking them to the next level. Because if we don't give them the best now, the next election will not be certain for us. That's why we have to put on our best. And let Nigeria feed the impact of government positively.
What assurance are you giving to Nigerians of a better life?
No, you have seen before, you have seen what you have done before in the area of social development, in the area of health, in education, and in project management of the economy and in security as well. So, and with that's what you for end us this future as well. Because you can't compare with us and the past government, the past administration. So that's the assurance.
Okay. What new things are you going to bring to the table?
A lot of, we have to consolidate what we have started, really. We have to consolidate. Like what you see before, when we came on board, we didn't start a new project as regards in road construction or road rehabilitation. We focus on the way the one we have to maintain. So we put those one in place. Like issue of railway, the one we made, we put it in place. In some of that, we put it in place. And we let Nigerians see that government can work, government can make things to work. So that's exactly what we do.
Thank you. What's your name?
I'm Honorable Tayo Tolagbaje. I'm the Director of Research, Planning and Strategy of the Buhari Oshimaju Mandate. And I'm the National Secretary as well.
My name is Dr. Onwuya Abraham Brayford, National Chairman of Freedom and Justice Party and presidential candidate.
Okay. All right. You've seen the victory gotten by President Muhammadu Buhari. Do you have anything to say?
Well, this is democracy in action. Our democracy is growing, is evolving. And you know, in the process of development, there will be TT problems. The process is free and fair. Transparent, may not be 100% transparent or credible, but it's to an extent that we can accept the result. And my advice is two, is that Mr. President, having won, should open his hand of fellowship to other presidential candidates to accommodate them in his government. That's a way of healing, that's a healing process. When people who are grateful, fed, they have spent a lot of money and they have lost, and you accommodate them, that's a way of healing the wound. And two, those who felt sad, very much aggrieved in this process, should use the legitimate means of addressing their grievances, going to the court. You know, if we use jumbo means of addressing our grievances or going to put laws in our hands, we'll throw the country into crisis and thereby destroy our nation. The nation wants to govern, it cannot destroy it. Remember that in 2003, Mr. Muhammadu Buhari contested for presidency, he lost to PDP. He went to court. 2007, he contested again, Muhammadu Buhari lost again in 2007, went to court, lost to the same PDP. Then 2011, contested for the presidency, he lost again, he went to court. 2051. So we have to be consistent. If you don't win today, you win tomorrow. Like we, who run this election, we lost a lot of money. We put a lot of effort, we lost. But I'm here today to embrace him. Because I believe that if you lose election, it's not do and die affair. If you lose today, you may win tomorrow. So we're here because we learned lesson from the past that he lost three times. The fourth time he won. So if he can lose election three times and won the fourth time, that means there's hope for us. So it's not a matter of I must be the winner. You know, we must accept defeat and embrace the winner, congratulate the winner, and work with him for the betterment of our nation. The nation Nigeria is bigger than any individual ambition. So I thank you.
Significant role in raising awareness and voter education. What would you say it has really helped this process?
Well, I think that the Nigerian people are engaged with the electoral process. If you saw what went on at the polling units, you can see that the ordinary people of this country believe in democracy, they believe in democratic process, and they believe in democratic values. So I think that what we need to do is to improve on this democratic culture and also see in what ways we can sustain it. But I think at a personal level, I feel slightly disappointed. Because if you look at the national average in terms of the voters' registration, the persons who are between the ages of 35 and 50 constitute almost 51% of the... I mean, those who are between 18 and 35 constitute almost 51% of those who registered. But having gone around the most of the polling units, it was very, very clear that they didn't make their numbers count. And that at the end of the day, the same people we saw at the polling units were elderly people who went to the polling units at 4 a.m. in the morning and remained and persevered and voted. Why the youths who were supposed to determine these elections were busy on social media? There are no polling booths on social media, and there are no voting points on social media. So no matter how long you tweet on social media, it will not translate into votes. So I think that the youth should be much more better engaged with the electoral process so that they can begin to have their voices heard and make their impact.
Okay, so lastly, yes. Sir, yes. For me, the numbers reveal that there's a lot of improvement in voter turnout despite demographic differences which you just highlighted. Sir, what was the secret behind your department's increase in voter education across board?
Yeah, we accelerated issues around voter education. But more importantly, I think that the Nigerian people engage with this particular process. The Nigerian people now believe that they have the capacity to make a difference. They believe that their votes can count in any electoral process. And that accounts for some of the turnout you saw in this particular election. We will continue to improve in terms of voter awareness and voter education. But I think that the youth that constitute over 51% of the registered voters in this country must buckle up, take the center stage, and lead the challenge for a new Nigeria. Unless they lead this particular challenge, our country cannot really, really move forward.
On a scale of 100%, in conclusion, how would you rate the 2019 general elections, journey so far?
I think that we have done our best. But as we move forward, we still have governorship and state assembly elections. We are going to improve on delivery in terms of logistics. We are going to also make sure that most of the coalition officers understand the regulations and the guidelines of the commission so that they can read them properly. Because what we have said is that the card reader is a mandatory process in our electoral process, and that we are not going to tolerate a situation where people are trying to deliberately undermine the use of the card reader in the electoral process. Any community that resists the use of the card reader, or any community that introduces violence into the electoral process because they don't want to use the card reader, that in that particular community, we are going to give them zero vote. So we must learn how to use the card reader, and we cannot jettison the card reader because it's a quality control mechanism for our electoral process. So that's one of the issues we are going to look into, and also look into issue of voter turnout and how we can deliver in terms of getting early to the various polling units.
Thank
so we are working, yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Following you, sir.